freshwater ecosystems, that's our lakes, our rivers, our reservoirs, occupy a tiny fraction of our planet, only about 3% of the terrestrial portion of our planet. Yet they emit as much greenhouse gases as the entire oceans combined do on an annual basis. The mission of the UNESCO Chair in Global Environmental Change is to assess the past, the current, and the future role of these freshwater ecosystems. And it also requires very varied expertises, from microbial ecology to biogeochemistry, biology, and even physics and modeling. The UNESCO Chair has allowed us not only to assemble this international team, but also to facilitate the development of projects here, but also abroad in Malaysia, French Guiana, and other parts of the world. Now, in our latitude, reservoirs are more or less saturated. There are still some new projects being developed, but it's really in the tropics that there is literally a boom in the development of reservoirs. What happens when we transform a terrestrial landscape flooded to create a new reservoir? Does it increase the carbon footprint of that landscape? Does it decrease it? Tropical reservoirs work very differently from the reservoirs that we have here in Quebec, for example. We would think that they would be really active. What we're finding, for example, is that very little methane is actually emitted from those systems, from the surface. In collaboration with the International Hydropower Association, we've been leading a project for the last few years now where we've developed a platform, a modeling platform, where the footprint, the greenhouse gas footprint of a reservoir can be estimated anywhere in the world. And it's now being used by already several international agencies. Over the next few years, we will be visiting hundreds of lakes in the various ecoregions of the country. And our role in the chair is to assess the carbon footprint of these systems and how it is related to what's going on in their drainage basin. In a nutshell, the UNESCO Chair in Global Environmental Change aims at understanding the various components of greenhouse gas emissions. It covers the entire spectrum, from detailed studies of individual system and individual processes to the development of global and practical models that are immediately societally relevant.